joke right from the beginning, you can go for it. So, looking at those a bit here. Just say, for example, Rob gets his hand at the top of his collar to defend like some people do. Maybe. Right? Check the leg. Rob knows what's coming back. So, we do exactly the same thing. Does that take him away? Shoves his own hand into his own neck. So it doesn't have to be a tight grip. Go over the hand. I'm starting to do this quite a bit. You know when people defend like this, it doesn't stop the choke. Some it'll make it difficult, but it won't stop it. If you want to defend a choke using hands like that, get your hand completely on your face. So that the collar is coming across your forearm. It's no good coming across your wrist because your wrist will bend in, won't it? So if you imagine a choke like that with somebody's body weight and they're leaving against you, it's going to fold your hand in. You've got a pretty strong forearm and a strong wrist to stop that happening. Yeah? So if the person looks to defend the neck like that, yeah, I'm trying to open it out, he's pulling, so I'm pulling back still, and I go over the top. I still want a tight grip. His hand's trapped as well now. So as I go here, I come out, so I can go this position here, slide the grip. Don't even need his leg from here. Stretch. His hand, where's he going to go? He can't turn that way. He can't turn that way because his arm's stuck. Sorry, Rob, you're all right.
Yeah, we're all
right. Yeah? So it doesn't matter which way he's going to go, he's done. Obviously, degree of flexibility required. This will put a killer on it. Yeah? Go for this, and I drop to the side, and I feel that I'm losing it. You know, it's on my thumb, the grip's not quite there. Okay? Straight away, I will put this leg on his arm and bring this over his shoulder. Grab my shin. And I'm going to keep hold of his chin, but I've let go of the collar. This leg comes up, kick, squeeze. Now look, I'll take the pressure off a little bit. Look at the angle of Rob's arm there. Because I've kicked, I brought his elbow up. Now, he's thinking triangle. I get upon my elbow, I put my elbow against his forearm, and I grab his wrist. And his shoulder off. So I'm not having to mess around, get one foot in the right position, things like that. So if it doesn't fall straight, I don't need it. See how the legs are controlling the arms? I'm trying to track and block. So, I've gone here. This is, like I say, I've gone too deep, so the grip will end up all on my thumb. Or if I've gone in my wrist bent like it is here. So I go there and it's not working. I think, well, I'm not going to finish this. I immediately come, try and trap that in. Okay? Go through. Grab my shin. Pull it. See, by lifting his head, I'm controlling his direction. I'm stopping him from getting up. And then I kick this leg up, stamp it out, and just lock it. And I'm after this. Some people are more flexible. Can even take it beyond. But while it's bent like that, even if I put my hand on his elbow and grab his wrist off. Or you can, if you wish, adjust yourself and finish the triangle off. If you're going to do that, same again. This is all kind of going wrong. So I've gone for the shin, up here, right, watch. As I get this position here, I'm going to turn my hips a little. Come under his arm to grab my shin again. Kick it and cinch it. Do this gently because I don't know how I need to take it. I'm going to kick his foot back and put it behind his hip. I'm going to sit up. Does that. Well, if you can reach forward and grab a leg, pull a leg over to you, see? And then just add another ingredient for not a lot of extra effort on your part. Okay? But do you see the little adjustment? It's like a triangle off your back. If the angle's not quite right, you'll feel it on the back of your calf. So with this, I adjusted, come round his head again, grab the shin, kick and lock it again. Then I start and sit up. So he drops, he's stuck. Grab his arms, I can use him, grab the leg. Yeah? Even grabbing the arms from there. Sorry, Rob, just trying to get away because he's not okay. Okay. Yeah. Go through. Here. Here, going wrong, trap this in. Look for this position. under his arm if I can, grab my shin, so I can even adjust up. See, I pushed on his hip, foot goes behind nice and easy. Right, I come up to the head, I leave my foot there, grab his elbow, do this gently because I can feel the pressure on his shoulder blade already. That's an old judo one. Not pleasant, is it? Doing it gently because people aren't with Carl. He'd be crying for his mum within seconds because he's got total inflexibility in his shoulder blades. So if you do that one and you don't pull it up, that one, pull it across the mat towards your hip. Do it slowly. So you get, like I said, I felt the pressure on his shoulder. You just ease it for him, so you finally can let me know. Try the other, if you do it too quick, you've got the cop with a coat on. And I know the weather's a bit better, but it has been raining. You might need a coat. Have a go with one or two of them, okay?